This Sunday on Close Up, our mayoral debate series continues with the candidates in Somersworth.
And good morning, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm Josh McKelvin, and welcome to week three of our mayoral debate series. This morning, we are talking to the candidates in Somersworth. I am again joined this morning by my colleague James Pindle of WMUR Political Scoop. Good to see you.
Good to see you. Let's do this.
All right. Well, the question is going to come from both of us as well as the viewers. We've asked folks on Facebook to send us some ideas. Candidates will get about a minute to respond to these questions. No official timers, but I will have to cut you off if you're going too long, and I will also offer rebuttals as needed. Once again, fair enough.
Fair enough.
All right. Well, this morning's debate, again, features the candidates in Somersworth. They are current Mayor Matt Spencer. He can be found on the left of your screen, while challenger Dana Hilliard is on the right. Just a few moments ago, we flipped a coin to see who's going to go first, to give you a little introduction, tell us why they're in this race. Mr. Hilliard, as the challenger, you won this toss. Tell us a little bit about yourself and why you're running.
Thank you very much, Josh and James, and I'd like to thank WMUR and Close Up for this opportunity to speak to the voters of Somersworth. For over 41 years, I've been able to call Somersworth my home. And our tight-knit community has seen me grow up, play within their neighborhoods, and be educated through their school system. Go on to Keene State College and receive my Bachelor of Arts in Political Science, go on to the University of Plymouth State to receive my M.E.D. in Education, and move back to my community to start my career in education as a social studies teacher. But eventually go on to be the assistant principal of the same high school that my mother graduated from, something that I take great pride in. And then move on to the middle school to become principal of a lot of the teachers that taught me. Somersworth is a great community, but is striving for proven leadership. Five times that community has sent me to the legislature to represent them, something that I am very proud of. Twice, Somersworth has elected me to the city council for my proven leadership record. I now ask the citizens of Somersworth to move me into the mayor's office so that I can continue to harvest the energy of the citizens to move our community forward.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hilliard. Mayor Spencer, tell the voters of Somersworth why they should give you a second term.
Good morning, Josh and James. Thank you very much, and WMUR Channel 9 for this invitation for us to address the citizens of Somersworth and state of New Hampshire. I'm not a politician. I'm a community member of the community, and I did that when I first ran 2 years ago, and I saw that our community was in dire need of leadership. Thoughtful, balanced, and professional leadership. So I stepped up to the plate and I ran. And I'm thankful for the voters of Somersworth to allow me that opportunity. I was in the Coast Guard for 20 years. I'm retired military. I've been all around the United States. I've called Somersworth my home since I was 6.5 years old. I was originally born in Cleveland, Ohio. So it was a vast difference coming from a big city to a population, well, now a population of 11,766 people thereabout. So I'm thankful. During the last 2 years, we've made major improvements in Somersworth. The downtown revitalization project is coming to fruition. The Somersworth Berg Bridge is going to be reconstructed, and that's in the works, and that is a gateway from the state of Maine into New Hampshire. And economic development is also on my agenda, and we have...
Mayor, we are going to get to plenty of that, but I said 1 minute for everybody's opening statements, and I'm sure James probably have a question related to that. James, take it away.
That's right.
Mayor, you've had this position of mayor for 2 years now. When you see people in the community, maybe when you go door to door, what do you point to as your greatest accomplishment, as the reason why you need another 2 years in office?
Well, I have brought thoughtful, professional, and balanced leadership to the office of the mayor, and the council definitely shows that. We've been able to work together. We've, like I said, started the downtown infrastructure, which was during my campaign in 2011, people wanted the downtown, something done with downtown, and with the bridge, and also with the tax rate. That has also been stabilized. So I want to see those projects finished before I pass it on to the next person. My intention was only to do two terms, and that's still my intention, to go back to be a member of the community. So thank you.
Thank you. Obviously, you would like it just to be one term. So have you been
Correct.
Satisfied with the job performance for the last 2 years from Mayor Spencer?
Well, I think Mayor Spencer and I, or Matt and I, have just two different visions. And the word that you use, leadership, is really a key word of defining this. Again, proven leadership with myself within the community. I've taken two schools and been part of inspiring a faculty for two schools for all intensive reasons were classified as failing schools. Somersworth High School now has a national reputation as a PBIS school and a model for schools throughout the country. Somersworth Middle School, where 3 years ago, before I walked in with my tenure, I've been able to work with that faculty, inspire them together as a team. And keyword, working together as a team, where we were just named this year as a spotlight school by the League of New England Middle Schools, something that we are very proud of. Only seven schools. We're the seventh school in New Hampshire to receive that award. That's why this evening, working as Matt pointed out, working together with the city council as a mayor is very important. That's why this evening I'm able to say seven of the nine city councilors are endorsing me to be elected as mayor. That is something that I take as a very big accolade as to the proven leadership that I have been able to exemplify within the community. And really, the mayorship is about working together as a team. We have a city manager-mayor form, which means the mayor is, for all intents and purposes, the chair of the city council and helps inspire the city council, keep the city council together and focused, and moves forward the vision to rally the community around so that we can continue to move forward into progress, something that I will be able to do in that office as mayor.
Mayor, you want to take 30 seconds to rebut?
Absolutely. I was in the Coast Guard for 20 years. I was a federal law enforcement officer, and we worked in teams because we depended on people to save our lives. I can say working in this job for the past 2 years, it's very much different. There are five wards, and the five demographics in each one of those wards are very different. The four at large, well, they can work together. They're for the whole city, if that's what their constituents want. But each ward has their own constituents, and their different problems, and their different issues. So it's up to those councilors to bring what their constituents want to the council. And I believe in a balanced, not always harmonious, council.